But interestingly enough, actually, I've spent quite some time here, and I'm going to be around here. I'm thoroughly impressed by the way the schools have organized themselves, the measures they have taken. In each of these schools I've gone to, they have over 50 hand-washing points. They are ready to deal with this, totally ready. And this is very impressive. So I want to assure everyone that I think all is well. So let's now proceed and support our teachers. Proceed and support our teachers, especially the head teachers, the school principals who are doing an extremely critical assignment for all of us as a country. So I don't even know if they get time to sleep, but we thank God for them, and we will back them. And I've told everybody, I've been meeting with my colleagues in Ngao, the teams in the security sector, everybody. The firm instruction from our president is this: Sisi wote, we support the principals and the schools to make sure that these schools run smoothly, and that our kids go through their studies without any interruption at all. So, no excuse, no nothing. Wale ambao wako, ndio tulikubaliana na wakuu wa usalama hapa, tuwatafute. My chiefs and assistant chiefs, I am very happy about our county commissioner here. I'm very proud of her. She has mapped out this very well with the Nyumbakumi. She has created all the Nyumbakumi clusters. She has the data of all of them. These 311 girls, wherever they are, we will get a report on each one of them and how life is going on. That is how government works. That is how government is going to work for the people that put it in place and put it in power. And those that have got challenges, for example, here in Tharaka Nithi, our teams led by the county commissioner have done a fantastic job keeping records and tracking our students through the Nyumbakumi system and so on. And we have a record that 311 girls in Tharaka Nithi are expecting. But we have agreed again, because of the teamwork we have with the county government and the Ministry of Education officials and Ngao, we know where each one of those 311 girls are. They go back to school, they will be supported, and we ensure that we fulfill the plan of government as has been clearly articulated by our president. So the focus this week is on our children. There's nothing else we are doing but supporting our children. And then truth be told, my heart goes out to head teachers and our school principals. I've said this several times before, there are no people who do a more difficult job than our head teachers and our principals. I mean, these wonderful people that God has placed in our midst are doing all of us proud. When you look at the way they have taken their responsibilities, the focus they are giving this, I thank them very sincerely on behalf of all parents in Kenya and on behalf of the government. Everywhere I've gone, including here, I've been here with Madam Muturi, and she has taken me through, and all of us, the plan she has and how she has worked to deal with this. His Excellency the President had directed that we ensure that we spend all our time this week supporting our colleague, the Minister for Education, Professor Magoa, and the education sector team to ensure that the return to school program goes on smoothly. That's why we are moving around, we've been to various places, and we're going to do this for the entire of this week to be sure that we are fine. So on behalf of my colleague, our Cabinet Secretary for Education, Professor Magoa, I want to say how grateful I am to our colleagues and our friends in the education sector. This is my third school now, here in Tharaka Nithi. I've been to Iku Girls. We've just spent time here with the principal. By yesterday, only about 45 students are not reported, but a good number of them have come in this morning. And thankfully, the principal is in touch with all the 45 students, and she knows where they are. I was in a school in the morning where 84 students are not reported. We agreed with the county commissioner and the regional commissioner and the education coordinator in the region and the county director of education and our TSC colleague that we are mounting a manhunt for those 84 students. The principal gave us the list. We are working on them, calling, assisting the principal, to call and make sure that those students are found and they come back to school. The other place where I went, only 12 students are not reported, but it's because they are transferred to another school and the head teacher had the records. So it is true, as our Cabinet Secretary for Education has informed us, that the return to school is actually hovering around over 97-98% that all our children have safely come back to school.